After dark, in the playing fields. The hour was late, and the night was fair. I had halted not far from Sheep's Bridge, and was thinking about the stillness, only broken by the sound of the weir, when a loud, tremulous hoot just above me made me jump. It is always annoying to be startled, but I have a kindness for owls. This one was evidently very near. I looked about for it. There it was, sitting plumply on a branch about 12 feet up. I pointed my stick at it and said, "Was that you?"
"Drop it," said the owl. "I know it ain't only a stick, but I don't like it. Yes, of course it was me. Who do you suppose it would be if it weren't?"
We will take as read the sentences about my surprise. I lowered the stick.
"Well," said the owl, "what about it? If you will come out here of a midsummer evening like what this is, what do you expect?"
"I beg your pardon," I said. "I should have remembered. May I say that I think myself very lucky to have met you tonight? I hope you have time for a little talk."
"Well," said the owl ungraciously, "I don't know as it matters so particular tonight. I've had me supper, as it happens, and if you ain't too long over it—" "Ow!"
Suddenly, it broke into a loud scream, flapped its wings furiously, bent forward, and clutched its perch tightly, continuing to scream. Plainly, something was pulling hard at it from behind. The strain relaxed abruptly. The owl nearly fell over, and then whipped round, ruffling up all over, and made a vicious dab at something unseen by me. "Oh, I am sorry," said a small, clear voice, in a solicitous tone. "I made sure it was loose. I do hope I didn't hurt you."
"Didn't hurt me," said the owl bitterly. "Of course you hurt me, and well you know it, you young infidel. That feather was no more loose than— Oh, if I could get at you. Now I shouldn't wonder but what you've throwed me all out of balance.